To make our mini forge, we're going to need a fire brick, 4 5/16-inch by 6-inch bolts, 8 fender washers, 4 nylon lock nuts, and a section of aluminum angle. And a propane torch, which next to the forge itself is the second most important item we'll need. To get started, we need to half our fire brick. Find the center point and then make a tick mark. Then, using a square, draw a line down the exact center of the brick. Next, using my compound miter saw, I have the brick. Just go slow and it slices like butter, and it gives a super clean cut. Now, over to the drill press, use a 2-inch hole saw and drill out the center of one of the bricks. Again, just go slow and it works great. If the center gets stuck in your bit, a few taps should set it free. We'll finish off the brick by drilling a 5/16-inch hole in the side of it that connects to the large center hole. When you're done, you should have a solid brick and a brick with two holes in it that will become our fire chamber. Take the aluminum angle out and measure off 4 6-inch sections, and then, using a cutting tool, cut them out. At the end of each aluminum section, drill a 5/16-inch hole. When finished, the completed section should have two holes on one side and look like this. And now it's time to assemble all the pieces. Take the aluminum sections and run the bolts through them with washers. Then, we'll place them on the bricks. Be sure that the side hole we drilled is situated on the left side towards the center of the bricks, and then install the next section of aluminum angle. Now go ahead and install the top straps, along with the fender washers and nylon lock nuts, and then hand tighten them. Using a 1/2-inch socket wrench, we now need to tighten up the straps. We want the straps to be secure, but do not over-tighten them, as doing so could fracture the bricks. And this is what our completed mini forge looks like. I sat the mini forge on top of a pan, inserted the propane torch, and fired it up. Within a few seconds, it was glowing red hot inside the fire chamber. And a few minutes later, we're ready to start using it. Using some long pliers, I took this scrap metal I had and placed it in the mini forge. It took about a minute, and it was glowing red hot. Well, in future videos, I'll show you how to use this forge to make all kinds of cool things. If you have a request, leave it in the comments. And if you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel on YouTube.